Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm Susan Joker, the creative director of Sujo Beats and Crafts, and today I'll be teaching us two things. I'll be teaching us how to make the bandless turban cap and also how to make this beautiful rose that is on the turban cap. Yes, you can make the rose and attach it to anything you want. You can make it with different sizes. So this is it. This is another one. Yes. So make one, a smaller one, and attach it to my headband. You can watch my previous video on how to make an headband. So I have the smaller size, the biggest, the big size, and the biggest size. You can increase your size, you can decrease it, depending on how you want your rose to come out. Isn't this looking beautiful, guys? Yes. This is very, very beautiful. So let's get started. Material needed are our lacquer fabric, tape room, tailor's chalk, scissors, office pin, then needle and thread, your glue gun, and your candy wax. Measure 24 inches wide by 15.5 inches length. 15.5 inches length by 24 inches wide, and set it aside. Also measure a long strip, two long strip of 4.5 inches wide by, I think this should be by, by 60.5 inches length. Now our base is 24 inches wide by 15.5 inches length. So I'll be folding my material like this, fold it in by 1 inch and sew it down to form the band of my turban cap. So fold your material in like this. You want to form the base, then we want to form our band from this fabric. So you measure 1.5 inches wide. Here, measure it straight down. Fold the edge into two like this. Fold this edge in like this. And sew it down so that we have our band. So I'll do that now and get back to us.
So after sewing to get my band, I fold my material into two and I measure 11 inches in fold, which is my head circumference. My head circumference is 22 divided by 2, making 11 inches. So I folded it 11 inches, then I mark it down like this and I make a curve. Our normal regular turban curve this way. So what I'll be doing next is I'll be sewing from this edge, sew it like this in a curve like this to the end here. Sew from here down to this end. So after sewing, I'll be making normal gathers to gather the back. So I'll do that and get back to us.
So I finished gathering the back of our turban cap, and this is how it looks like. So you turn it to the right side, and this is it. This is the back, and this is the front. So what I'll be doing next is I'll be making our rose that I'll be attaching on the turban cap. For our rose, I measured 90 inches length by 5 inches wide. That is 19 inches length by 5 inches wide, and I cut it out. After cutting out my 19 inches length by 5 inches wide, what I did was I fold the material into two and I secured the edges with pin. Make sure that the two edges are touching each other, so you pin it down to the end. So after pinning it down, what you'll be doing is you'll be making running stitches. You gather it, you make the running stitches. Yeah, you're not making running stitches at the edges of the fabric where we cut, but we'll be making running stitches at the folded parts. Yeah, at the folded part. Normally our regular, this we used to make our gathers at the cut part here where I pin, but for this design we'll be making the stitch along the folded parts here. You make the running stitches from here down to the end of your fabric, from here down to the end of the fabric. So I'll do that and get back to us. So I finished making my running stitches and this is how it looks like. This is it. So what you'll be doing next is you fold, as in you make it like a circle, turn it like this, the normal way we used to do our rows. Make it circle, keep doing it circular form, and you tack it down with your needle and thread, or you cut a small piece of fabric, a round fabric, a circular form or a triangular form, anyhow you want it to be. Then you place it on it. So now I cut a small round object and I make a spiral shape on it. So I'll be attaching my rows on this round object. You can start from the edge here, you can start from the middle. So you keep doing it, keep attaching it with your glue gun till you cover it up to the circle. So you cover your rows on your circle. So I'll attach my rows to my round object. You can use your felt material, you can use any thick fabric of your choice, you can use any available fabric to do it. So I'll do that now and get back to us. Attaching our rows to the circle I cut the other time. This is the front and this is the back. Yes, isn't this looking very beautiful? Yeah, so what I'll be doing next is I'll be attaching these rows to our turban cap. So this is it. So I still remain our one and only Susan Joke of Sujo Beads and Craft, the creative director of Sujo Beads and Craft. So tell us, you can increase your length, you can decrease your length. Here I use 90 inches by 5 inches length. The one on this, our headband, I use 4 inches by 45 inches length. And also the one on this turban cap, I used 65 inches length by 4 inches wide. So you can increase it, you can decrease it anyhow you want it. Either you want it big, or you want it small, or you want it a medium size. Yeah. So please and please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Click on the notification bell beside the subscribe button to get notified anytime we post a new video. If you find this video helpful, please click, give it a thumbs up, click on the like button. Comment if you have any issue while making this rose and the turban cap. So thank you so much for watching. I love you all. Bye bye.